He said, Zacchaeus, I'm going to come to your house to eat tonight. Right? What's Zacchaeus? He said, man, if I took any money from anybody, I'm going to give it back. Man, if I did this, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. The anointing caused him to release and come into repentance. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And the anointing of love and understanding.
Yeah.
Okay? And I have one pastor say, you need to tell your men to do this, and you need to tell your men to do this, and you need to tell them to act like this. I said, first of all, they're my sons, and they will do what I ask them to do. Okay? All right? What you need to know, that they're men, and that none of us are finished.
Yeah.
And I will sit them down and tell them what I think I need to tell them, not what you
think. All right.
Well, come on.
That's the order. I know somebody.
Amen.
My Lord Jesus.
Amen.
I'm going to tell you a cryptic story. One of my men was on the mission field, and some guy went crazy and knocked him upside the head a couple times.
Wow.
Right? So he waited for the guy to come out and just beat his body up a little bit, right? And I didn't know why it was going on, but I went outside and I looked at it and I said, oh, okay. And I went back. So he said, man, the guy came and slapped me upside my head twice. He said, the first time I gave him a pass, but then he popped me upside the head again. I said, man, I'm glad I didn't see that, because I would have taken a chair and busted him all upside his head. I'm serious. That's my wonder, man. What are you doing, man? Bam! Because my hands are worth a lot of money. I got beautiful hands and stuff like that. I'm going to get a chair. A chair. And pop him up. He probably would have died.
Yeah.
All he did was get hit in the ribs or something. Amen?
Amen.
Sometimes you got to leave things alone.
Yes.
Yeah.
And know that you have trained people in the gospel.
Yeah.
Right. Amen? And that we walk together because we can agree. I'm so glad I did not see that I was in another part of the building. I would have jumped all in his face with a chair. Okay? Come on, somebody.
The Holy Ghost.
Come on. Y'all see, y'all not hearing.
God
is merciful when you don't think he's merciful. And grace and mercy come together when you don't even know what's going on.
Amen.
Now, I'm just saying, I don't know who has to release somebody, but as long as you cannot release, then you'll never be able to fully go back to your father's house. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. If there's somebody that needs to release and you're stuck in the release process, I just want to lay hands on you, anoint you, amen, that you have the power to release. But guess what? You can't release anybody until you release yourself.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Hello. He prophesied.
He gave a prophetic call.
It was a prophetic call.
Amen.
A prophetic call. It's time to release.
Amen.
Amen.
And let go. Okay? Release and let go.
Yes.